All right, Greg, so do you think it's a good idea to start my resume with my key accomplishments or professional summary?
So one of the things I see, Henry, and first of all, the answer to that is no, but I wouldn't delete those things. A lot of resumes I see people write, especially when they have a private sector resume and they're trying to convert into a federal resume, is they open up top, and it's usually a paragraph or two. It's a little narrative that states their professional accomplishments. They tell a little bit of a story. Or their key accomplishments or specialized skills, and they talk about that up top. Now, you can do that. I recommend you don't do that. The reason being is because you give that narrative and you're explaining a lot of things that you accomplish or skills that you have, the human resources specialist that is reviewing your resume and trying to qualify, you cannot directly connect that to any specific job, any specific length and time in that job, any specific pay grade that you are working with, so at what level you were doing with. So what I tell people to do is to not remove that, but then get all those skills and accomplishments and plug it into the resume under specific job headings.
Okay.
Right? Because you want to make sure that we could tie, okay, for example, I did this little project. Well, what company were you working for? So you want to put it in there. When you do that, you could tie it to, I did it for 4 years with this company. I did it at this pay grade. I did it at. So it gives the HR specialist a little bit more of an understanding of what you did, but then how long, at what level, and what company you were working for. Was it a private sector company? Was it a federal job, federal agency, or whatnot? So that's why I recommend remove it off to the side, but then use those things and plug them into the specific jobs that you've worked with.
So would that be like the paragraph that you kind of open up with? Don't use the paragraph.
Don't use the paragraph.
Use the information that's inside of the paragraph under the particular jobs that
Absolutely.
You did.
Absolutely, because when you list your jobs, you're going to list it, I work for this company from this month and year to this month and year. So let's say it's 4 years long. I did it for, I don't know, $25 an hour, and I did 40 hours a week. Now, when you tell me about that accomplishment, I can tie it to that specific job, because when you put it up top, under no specific heading, their HR specialist has to wonder, well, how long did they do this? What company were they? Was it a public sector, private sector job? Was it in the military, civilian side of the house? So they're not going to ask those questions. They're just going to not count them and not give you credit for it.
Oh, okay.
So again, we want to make sure we tie it to that. Does that kind of make sense?
Right, that makes sense.
Okay.